Often, we find ourselves from a conversation surrounding about investments and savings. While we may not be aware, most of us use these terms interchangeably, not realizing just how different both these activities are. Watch this video fully to get idea about the importance of investment than saving, and at the end of the video we will give a real-time example about savings versus investment. So don't skip this video, and now let's begin. A lot of individuals who have stacked their money in the saving bank account think that they are already invested. Even though saving is the first step towards investing, one should understand the difference between two and not confuse the terms saving with investing. Wealth accumulation starts with the understanding that investing is not the same as saving. Let's learn the key difference between saving and investing. Saving refers to part of your income which has not been spent on consumption and personal needs. It is the money left back in your account after taking care of all your fixed and monthly expenses like rent, utility bills, food, fuel, repairs, and others. When you have emergency fund, you can avoid the need to swipe your credit card and save yourself from falling into debt trap. Saving money regularly doesn't lead to wealth creation. You need to invest same in some financial product in order for it to grow. Saving is the safer route because dollar amount in your bank account won't typically decrease unless you withdraw funds. But interest rates on the saving account doesn't allow your money to grow very quickly. Unfortunately, interest rates are often lower than the rate of inflation. This means your saving could lose purchasing power over time. On the other hand, investing is the part of saving that is employed in financial products, extending but not limited to mutual funds, gold, and any other in order to earn a return on investment. The return on fixed income products like FDs are earned in form of interest on the money invested. In avenues like mutual funds, your wealth grows by way of an increase in the value of investments and dividends received. It's tempting to want to invest to receive higher returns and beat inflation. Unfortunately, the value of your investments won't always go up. In case investments can become completely worthless. So, you need to take care while investing and saving money. So, in next section, we will see what is the period of investment. The time period for saving varies considerably from the period of investing for financial goals. Your savings would stay in your bank account for as long as you want, with the options for you to access the funds in case of any emergency. On the other hand, for purpose of investing, the saving may remain invested in financial products until you reach your set goal. The investment horizons for bigger goals like buying a house or planning for retirement can be as long as 15 years. But there are also some risk involved. This risk related to return earned while you save versus when you invest. Banks have been known to provide the highest level of safety for the money deposited with them. When you hold your savings in bank account of reputed bank, you are bound to earn interest income at the fixed rate. The risk of not getting the interest income is very low. However, investing in market-linked financial products like stocks or mutual funds is quite different. In this case, your investments are subject to market risk. This may cause your fund value to fluctuate in response to the movements of stock market. That is why you should always invest in mutual funds and other market-linked securities, keeping your risk tolerance in mind. Now let's check about returns potentials. Rewards are incidental to the risk taken by an investor. Those who take higher risk tend to earn higher returns in the long run. A bank account may be safest place to keep your savings, but you tend to earn very low returns. These returns might not be sufficient to grow your wealth or make you rich in long run. Conversely, investing money in capital markets might not be as safe as saving bank account, but you are compensated with much higher returns, which helps to accomplish bigger financial goals in life. Now let's check about how easy you can access this. Liquidity is one crucial aspect that differentiates saving from investing. Money held in liquidity funds provide you easy access to cash in times of need. In case of long-term investments like NPS, PPF, access to invested capital is restricted and one is bounded by the lock-in period. Even tax-saving mutual funds or ELSS funds come with lock-in period of 3 years, which is considered to be shortest among all other tax-saving alternatives. As an investor, your decision should always be guided by your financial goals and investment horizons. Now, what things need to keep in mind while saving or investing? Let's see. While you save, don't ignore your important expense just because you want to grow your corpus. Make proper provisions for all your necessities. Avoid unrealistic expectations from your investments. They need time to grow. Draw a proper plan to meet your short-term and medium and long-term goals without impacting your day-to-day life. Proper guidance and better results. Always consult an investment planner for time to time. Now, what is the bottom line? Saving is the first step towards money management and become imperative not just with regarding to meeting emergencies but for building wealth too. While saving is more important, it is alone not sufficient. For wealth accumulation and bigger financial goals, one must explore investment options that best suit their risk profile and financial objectives. So here, let's take one example. Consider you earn 60,000 per month. Sounds interesting, right? Yeah, I know. And consider you spend 30,000 per month towards your cost of living, which may include house, food, transport, shopping, medicals, and many more. The balance of 30,000 is your monthly surplus. And consider the employer is kind enough to give you 10% salary hike every year. And also, we know the cost of living go lightly up by 8% year on year. Now, you are 25 years old and you plan to retire at 60 years. Now, you are having 35 more years to earn and you decided not to work after your retirement. And now let's consider your expenses are fixed and don't force any other expenses. The balance cash of 30,000 per month is retained in the form of hard cash. Going with assumption, here is a look of your cash balance in 25 years. So, if you plot your annual income as the function of your age, so it will go on increasing 10% per year. So, at the age of 25, your annual income will be 7.2 lakh, which will become approximately 11.5 lakh at the age of 30, which will grow to 30 lakhs at the age of 40, and at the time of retirement, your annual income will be 2 crore. Wow, that's a great news. And your expenses is 30,000 per month, which is 3.6 lakhs per annum. And as the inflation rate is 8%, expense will increase 8% per year, which will become 11.4 lakhs per annum at the age of 40. And at the age of retirement, it will be 53 lakhs per annum. And now, as you are saving 30,000 per month, or we can say 3.6 lakhs per annum, it will keep on adding every year. Within 15 years, you will accumulate 57.6 lakh and at the age of retirement, it will grow up to 1.3 crore. This looks really amazing that with regular saving, we can accumulate huge amount of bank balance in 35 years. but the actual problem will occur when you will retire. After retirement, your salary will stop. That means your income will be zero. Assuming that expense will continue to grow at 8%, rupees 1.3 crore good enough for you for next 6 to 7 years of your post-retirement life. 7th year onwards, you will be in a tight spot with literally no savings left. What you will do after 7 years of retirement? How do you fund your life? Now consider you selected to invest instead of keeping your cash ideal as saving. Let's consider some investment plan which will give 10% returns annually. In the first year, 3.6 lakh rupees invested, and it keeps on adding every year. So after 15 years, it will become 1.4 crore. And at the time of retirement, it will become around 11.8 crore. So, with the good decision of investment, your surplus cash increased significantly. So, the cash balance grown from 1.3 crore to 11.8 crore. So, this investment transits you in much better situation to deal with your post-retirement life. So you can plan your post-retirement trips very easily. But the main thing is it won't stop at your retirement. Your investment will grow after your retirement also. Finally, I just want to say it is smart to make money. And it is smarter still to make your money work for you to grow your wealth. So that's all in this video. If this video is informative, hit that like button and please subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.